the occupation of the West Bank of the River Jordan, all territory taken by Israel in the Six-Day War more than 10 years ago. Nablus, an Arab town in occupied territory, in the West Bank, where for 10 years 700,000 Palestinians have lived under martial law. Mr. Begin claims that occupation secures Israel from destruction. The Americans offer an alternative security, buffer zones treaties. Israel prefers occupation. The people here are ruled by an alien army. In the West Bank, Israel challenges the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. And the Palestinians see in the PLO their only hope of salvation.
Did the people here feel that the PLO in the Lebanon was fighting for the people of the West Bank?
Yes, we have a feeling, and it's a fact, that they are fighting for the Palestinian existence, for the Palestinian people, you see. It's not for us, not for them, but for all of us as Palestinians, you see, for our right, for a homeland, you see. The Jews have had their homeland, they have their own state. Okay, but we want our state as well.
Do you regard the guerrilla fighters in the Lebanon as your fighters?
Yes, they are Palestinians, you see, and the PLO is our representative. So all their resources are ours, of course.
For the moment, it is quiet in the West Bank. But last week, there were violent demonstrations against Israel's invasion of Lebanon. And the young, who stand in the front line against the occupation, suffered severe reprisal at the hands of the army. But among these Palestinians, the prestige of the PLO has never been higher, and their hatred for the army of Israel never fiercer. Mr. Begin's offer of local autonomy in the West Bank under continued Israeli occupation is more strongly rejected than ever.
About local autonomy and local leadership to represent the Palestinians, the Israelis have been trying to do this for a while, but this is not acceptable to us. This is unacceptable because we feel that the problem is not only ours, it is the problem of the Palestinians. We have the Palestinians who are homeless, living outside the occupied territories, and we cannot claim that it is our own problem here, and then we can negotiate with the Israelis on behalf of everybody. On what to negotiate? As long as there is no solution for the Palestinians, it means that there will be no peace. So nobody will achieve peace without solving the Palestinian problem, because it is the core of the problem.
Unless the PLO is suppressed, of course.
Even though, I mean, we are not prepared to negotiate for something short of a Palestinian state and homeland, you see. So whether the PLO is suppressed or not, but the Palestinians are there.
Minister, do you believe that the West Bank is part of the State of Israel and should so remain, or that if the conditions were right, Israel should withdraw from the West Bank?
I think that the whole problem is being tackled too black and white-like. And I'm not avoiding the issue, but I'd like to elaborate a little bit. First of all, I tackle it from a security point of view. Nobody in Israel wants or will let the borders be 8 miles from the sea as they used to be before 67. Therefore, I think it's a grave mistake for anyone to tell us back to 67 with minor modifications.
Does that mean that you believe that Resolution 242, calling for withdrawal from occupied territories, with Mr. Begin, do you believe that it does not apply to the West Bank?
First of all, I don't tackle 242. Just think. Look, if you'd let me elaborate a little bit more. When the Egyptians come and say that the Sinai is sovereign part of Egypt, they have a legal right to say so because the Sinai was always part of Egypt. We can discuss with them and argue with them that if after 30 years of battles and wars, we need certain security measures, this airfield, that airfield, we'll discuss, we'll come to a conclusion. If ever the Syrians come and say the Golan Heights are sovereign part of Syria, they have a legitimate right, we shall discuss with them whether after 30 years and security problems, it goes back to Syria or not. Western Bank was never sovereign part of Jordan. It was never sovereign part of Israel either. Gaza was never sovereign part of Egypt.
Does that mean that you do not...
That means that both Gaza and the Western Bank are completely different to the Sinai and the Golan.
You don't...
Therefore, you cannot take a scheme and by black and white say, since there is a decision, everything back to 67, minor modification, therefore it applies to everything. I think that it definitely applies to all parts, but every part should be discussed separately when a discussion will happen, I hope, in the future.
But the pressure from the Americans, which has caused the great problems you now have with the United States, has been to recognize that you have to withdraw from the West Bank, given certain guarantees.
I wouldn't like to go into what happened in Washington the last few days, but I believe that if we sit with the Egyptians facing each other, with nobody helping us, that we'll just sit at us, be facing an Egyptian leader like I'm facing you, and I've done it about five times already. I think there is a possibility, if we don't go into all the legalistic details of this, that, or the other, I think that there is a chance of coming to an understanding. I might be wrong, but I think that we should give it a chance.
That would be a peace just between yourselves and the Egyptians.
If it's impossible to get what is known as a comprehensive peace treaty, I'd rather have something than nothing.
If you could get a comprehensive peace treaty which involved withdrawal from the West Bank, would you withdraw?
We have said and we keep saying, in any arrangement, Israel stays in the Western Bank, especially from a military point of view.
And the West Bank is the key, because there live the hopes of the Palestinians. And so the crisis over the West Bank is inseparable from the crisis in the Lebanon. Israel has now been in occupation here for 2 weeks, her withdrawal not yet begun, threatening to stay if Palestinians keep up the attack. Israel has always feared destruction, but argues from strength, seeking security in occupation. But that means land without peace, a choice that is only made when you know that the massed armies of your enemy would collapse before your military might. The Palestinians are hardly an army, but they are still there, grouped a mere mile from the Israeli front line, ready to fight. The PLO is not wiped out, and their morale is high. They have demonstrated as never before that there can be no peace in the Middle East which ignores their claim to Palestine, and their will is eternal.
We are homeless. As long as we are homeless, we will go on fighting. They want to liquidate our cause. They want to liquidate our personality as a people. They want to turn us into Red Indians, but we will not turn into Red Indians. We are Palestinians, we lived in Palestine, we are born in Palestine, and why should I, who is born in Palestine, live as a refugee all over the world, and Menachem Begin, who is not a Palestinian, and who was born somewhere in Europe, live in my own home? We will not be finished as a people. On the contrary, we were, we are, we shall always be